Imagine being a property owner, and while walking across your land, an EPA law enforcement agent approaches you on your property, handcuffs you, and puts you in jail, and fines you thousands of dollars. What happened? Without your knowledge, your land has been designated a critical habitat for Mississippi gopher frog. The Mississippi gopher frog may not be actually endangered, may have never hopped on your land, and may never hop on your land, but a group from the Fish and Wildlife Service stood over a map with their coffee and a magic marker and started randomly drawing the parameters. Your land was included. So it is determined that a frog might hop on your property at some time in the future. And therefore, you cannot walk on your property during certain months of the year. If you do, you will be fined and possibly arrested. Additionally, you cannot dig a well, build a fence, cut down trees, add onto your house, participate in any agricultural activities, or build an outbuilding, etc. Unfortunately, these new restrictions severely reduce the value of your property because of regulations placed upon your land. You will be forced to sell your land below value or surrender it to the government or a nonprofit organization receiving funds to implement the United Nations Agenda for Sustainable Development. You see, there were meetings this property owner could have attended concerning this land designation as a critical habitat area, but any resistance to the actions would have been dismissed. Questions officially submitted would never be answered. The listening meetings are intentionally named hearings to misguide the public into thinking there is something just about it. But indeed, there is nothing just. Your opinions and rights are dismissed. The frogs have more rights to your land than you who have paid taxes on the property, possibly for generations. Like an orchestra is coordinated, the musicians are on the same page, playing the same song. The score has been written by the United Nations. With the anticipated grand finale of loss of property rights, the orchestrated plan was executed by many players working together in perfect harmony. But to speed things along before people could catch on to the scheme and make a lot of noise, UN-affiliated groups file a suit against the Fish and Wildlife Service and the Secretary of Interior for failure to act swiftly. Perhaps a property owner was told that his land would not be included in the restrictions because his land was not included in the federally connected land like HUD homes are. Unfortunately, without the property owner's knowledge, an amendment was later applied to include his property because he had a federal home loan sold through Fannie Mae or Freddie Mac. Jump to the present day.